I want to start off with two numbers, 35 million, 36 billion. 35 million people worldwide are currently living with HIV, and a recent study indicated that the economic burden of new HIV infections in the United States alone in 1 year was $36 billion. Hold that thought. I work on viruses. Simple enough. In the Atwood Laboratory at Brown University, we study human polyomaviruses. And you've probably never heard of these viruses for a very good reason. They don't do anything to you if you're healthy. But it turns out that these viruses infect up to 70% of the human population. And if you have a severely weakened immune system, these viruses reactivate, travel to your brain, and cause a fatal neurodegenerative disease called PML for short. So here we have a situation where we have a virus that's either really good at hiding from your immune system, or your immune system is really, really good at controlling it. I work on how polyomaviruses interact with your immune system. And your immune systems over time have developed really cool ways at generally dealing with pathogens. One of these cool ways is that cells in your body have specialized proteins that recognize patterns in molecules that shouldn't be there. And so when one of these cells and specialized proteins recognizes a pattern that screams, hey, a virus is here, it signals to other immune cells to clear the infection. I'm working on how, after polyomavirus infection, the virus manipulates these signals, turning them on or off, up or down, and the subsequent downstream signals from that. Understanding this can help us understand why these viruses are not cleared completely from your body and they remain persistent. Another really cool way that your immune system has developed to deal with pathogens are by producing proteins called defensins. They're named that way for a reason. They provide a very good first line of defense by either being able to directly neutralize viruses and bacteria or by signaling just like the specialized pattern recognizing proteins. And I am following, using different microscopes, a polyomavirus infection throughout the cell after being treated with defensin and figuring out where the virus is stuck in the cell. Because the defensin indeed neutralizes infection, and I'm trying to figure out where on the virus's journey it does this. And by figuring this out, we can more directly target what compartment in the cell to use for treating this virus infection, and it could potentially have other implications with other persistent pathogens. But let me bring you back to that thought I told you to hold on to a little while ago. Why did I start off with HIV when I work on polyomaviruses? Well, if you didn't know, HIV destroys your immune cells, and PML was originally thought to be an AIDS-defining illness. But I bet many of you in the audience know somebody with multiple sclerosis, or Crohn's, or lupus, or any other autoimmune conditions. It turns out that the treatment for these conditions, or turning down your immune system, or in some cases turning it off, provide a really ripe environment for polyomaviruses to reactivate. So with new medicines and new elegant treatment strategies, we have unforeseen complications that we may not have been aware of before. So it's interesting. This summer I taught with a colleague of mine a summer course for pre-college kids called Exploring Infectious Diseases, Are We Safe? And I think we have a pretty good idea on the answer to that question, for better or for worse, for popular infections such as flu, Ebola, Salmonella. But my research hopes to answer a more nuanced and difficult question. Are we really safe from these pathogens and persistent infections that so far we've been able to control? With new medicines and new treatment technologies, some of these questions are harder to answer because they open up different problems. So in my mind, at least 35 million people and $36 billion are at stake. Thank you.